Let us pray. Father and our King, we worship you this morning. Jehovah God, we bless your holy name. We have come this morning to thank you for all that you have done for us since last Saturday.
Thank you, Father.
To express our gratitude to you for all of your provision, protection, and mercy and grace. As we go into this solution hour, let your name be at the forefront of everything. We surrender unto you and declare, we are the clay, you are the potter.
Yes.
Mold us and make us after Amen. Your own will.
Amen.
Let every burden that is brought to your feet this morning be met by the power of the resurrection.
Amen.
Blessed be your holy name.
Hallelujah.
We worship and adore you.
Yes,
in
Lord.
Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Come, thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet, sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mount, I'm fixed upon it, mount of thy redeeming love. Here I raise my Ebenezer, here by thy great help I've come, and I hope by thy good pleasure, safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger, interposed his precious blood.
Precious blood.
That day when freed from sinning, I shall see thy lovely face. Clothed then in blood-washed linen, how I'll sing thy sovereign grace. Come, my Lord, no longer tarry, take my ransomed soul away. Send thine angels now to carry me to realms of endless day. Oh, to grace, how great a debtor daily I am constrained to be. Let thy goodness, like a fetter, bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it. Prone to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above.
Amen.
Here, I raise my Ebenezer. Here, by thy great help I have come, and I hope by thy good pleasure safely to arrive home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This morning, I want to bring to our attention the story of the demon-possessed man that was healed in Mark chapter 5. This man was possessed by thousands of demons. This man lived in graveyard. That's the depth of his problem, his challenges. This man, when they even tried to chain him to get him under control, the demons were so powerful in him that he broke the chains. But at the presence of Jesus, he found solution.
Amen.
He was delivered from even thousands, not one, thousands of demons that have taken control of his life. That is the miracle that he saw. But that is not where I want to go this morning. This man, like the psalmist says, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I'm paraphrasing because he said to Jesus, I am going with you. Guess what Jesus told him? By the way, the story of his deliverance was told by many people. But when he told Jesus that he wanted to go with Jesus, Jesus' response we can find in verse 18, and the man's response we find in verse 20. Let me read for you to start our testimony hour this morning. And as Jesus began to get into the boat to depart, the man who had been set free from demons asked him, "Could I go with you?" Jesus answered, "No," but said to him, "Go back to your home and to your family and tell them what the Lord has done for you. Tell them how he had mercy on you." That is where I'm going, brothers and sisters. What has God done for you? This is your family. Would you share with us? And I will start. This week, a major appliance quit in my house. And I called a plumber that I had always used, whom we went to church together. And this man set a bill that was impossible. I was flustered. I had to go to work in a mode that did not prepare me to do my work properly. And I came home, complained about the bill to my wife, and my wife said, "Why don't you call Brother X, another brother that I'm going to church with right now?" I hesitated, but something within me would not let me rest. I called the other brother. The other brother said, "I will meet you at the store tomorrow. You will buy that appliance for cheap because I will use my contractor's discount to help you buy it. And guess what? I will use my truck to bring it home for you, which would have cost me another 100 plus. And guess what? I will find somebody to install it for you." And when that guy came to install it at the end, I said, "How much do I owe you?" Instead of $650, the guy says $150. I was so joyed, I gave him $50 extra. I said, "Have lunch on me." You know, this God that we serve, he works in ways that we cannot fathom.
Yes.
He, in my own situation, delivered me from unnecessary, exorbitant expense. Through it all, I saved almost $500.
Man.
that would have gone down the drain. This is my testimony that I have brought to the family. Just like the demon delivered man, this is what the Lord has done for me. What has the Lord done for you? Anybody?
Yeah, this is Dr. Sigi.
Good morning, Mama.
Good morning, sir. I experienced one sickness this last week, and I don't know where it came from. I was just coughing, my nose was running, and everything I did, it won't work. Not until I came to my children, I mean Bishop. I was asking for bitter cola. I don't know whether you all know what I'm talking
about. Yes,
yes. Because he always puts some cola and that cola in his fridge. I said, just bring everything, I will take it. They gave me the Orogbo, but still, my nose was running. I was wearing mask and everything so that I won't contaminate anybody. But later on, they gave me one, I don't know what you call that sweet name, the candy that was inside. I took it, and since then, I've been doing fine.
Okay. Amen.
Hallelujah. So hallelujah.
I pray that the Lord will give us good children. I really appreciate what they've done for me.
Hallelujah.
And I love them for that. I love everybody.
Hallelujah. Including me.
Yeah, including you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Father, Amen. We thank you, we worship you, we adore you, we exalt your holy name. Your word told us while we were yet sinners, Christ died. In other words, before we face our challenges, you already have prepared the solution for us. Thank you for the children that you have surrounded Mama with. Thank you for your provisions for those children. Thank you for the wisdom that you have placed in their hearts to even administer what will deliver Mama from even this cold. Father, we bless your holy name. We do not minimize what you have done in this case. In fact, we are testifying to the power of your name, of your deliverance. Blessed be your holy name, and we commit Mama into your hand, that Lord, you will continue to be with her. You will continue to abide with her. You will continue to give her joy in her heart. You will continue to give her good health, that the rest of the way will be lived in your presence, because we know in your presence there is fullness of joy. And at your right hand there are blessings forevermore. Oh, hallelujah. In Jesus' Amen. Mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Who wants to tell the family what the Lord has done for them this morning?
Worthy, worthy, worthy is the Lamb of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We thank God for his mercy. Last week, my son, just in the night, around after 11 to 12, he started coughing. Cough was so much that he has to drive out to CVS. Is it CVS they call it?
CVS. Yes.
To go and buy cough syrup. He bought the cough syrup, he brought it home, he took it. It was not doing anything. He coughed and coughed and coughed all morning. So all throughout the night, by the morning, the cough subsided. So I was thankful to God. Then, in the night of the following day again, this cough started again. This cough always gets stronger and stronger in the night. So around after 3, we have to go to the emergency. There they did some tests and said he was having bronchitis. I say in America, they baptize everything. It will not be our portion. He took the drug they prescribed for him. He was taking it. And as he was taking, and he's somebody who always liked to take cold water. He would take water from the fridge and still put ice cube. It is not right. So I started boiling water for him. I made sure he doesn't take any cold thing again. So this time around, he's taking warm water, even warm water to drink after food. Now doing that, and the cough, by God's grace, have subsided. He will just cough, and that is all. And it's improving. I give glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Healing hand.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you.
Thank you, Father.
We thank you that when we run to you,
oh yes, oh.
You run to us. You say, come nigh unto me. Mm-hmm. Unto you. And when we bring our troubles to you, you deliver us from our troubles, no matter how many they are. In this case, Father, Lord, it was an issue of coughing that was brought to you, and you delivered your son from this coughing. We are asking, Lord, that you make this healing abiding.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
That he will not suffer this again, but he will be healed through and through. Amen. And we thank you for mothers around us. We thank you for the passion that you have placed in them. We are thanking you in particular for Mama Mensa. We're thanking you for your spirit that you have placed in her to be able to move and to know what to do. Thank you for your Holy Spirit that you put in her to nudge her to know what to do in this situation, to put her faith in you and to accept the direction that you have moved her.
Yes, Lord.
Blessed be your holy name.
Hallelujah.
Father, we cover that entire family in the blood of Jesus, from the crowns of their head to the soles of their feet, to be sufficient shield for them against any and every fiery dart of the enemy, that no weapon formed or fashioned against them prospers, that every tongue that rises against them in judgment be condemned, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Healing upon each and every one of them, in the mighty name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
What is the Lamb?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I return all the glory and honor to God for answering our prayers.
Hallelujah.
The last time we met, I made mention of my son who was admitted in the hospital.
Yes.
And the brethren, we rallied around him and prayed for him. And the prayers of the saints availed much.
Availed much. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He's healed. He's discharged. He's living healed and hearted.
Amen.
So the glory unto God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Indeed, in your presence, there is fullness of joy. Because your son was ill, and brethren came together and brought him into your presence in prayer. And you have delivered your son. And for this, we are thanking you this morning, because of the demonstration of your power in and through his life. Now then, Lord, we commit your son into your hand. Let him continue to grow in wisdom, in stature, to the fullness of the measure of the stature of Jesus Christ, that he will not be distracted in this environment. He will not look to the left nor to the right, but he will set his face like a flint towards you, Father Lord. He will be taught by you, and he shall be great in the land, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Blessed be your holy name, we worship and adore
you. Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen.
What is the Lamb?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Scripture reading for today's solution hour
shall be taken from the book of Exodus, chapter 33, from verse 12 to chapter 34, 14. Let us hear the word of God. Exodus 33 from verse 12 says, Moses said to the Lord, See, you have said to me, Bring up these people, but you have not let me know whom you will send with me. Yet you have said, I know you by name, and you have also found favor in my sight. Now, if I have found favor in your sight, show me your ways, so that I may know you and find favor in your sight. Consider too that this nation is your people. He said, My presence will go with you, and I will give you rest. Mm. And he said to him, If your presence will not go, do not carry us up from here. For how shall it be known that I have found favor in your sight and your people, unless you go with us? In this way, we shall be distinct, I and your people, from every people on the face of the earth. The Lord said to Moses, I will do the very thing that you have asked for. You have found favor in my sight and know you by name. Moses said, Show me your glory, I pray. And he said, I will make all my goodness pass before you and will proclaim before you the name, the Lord. And I will be gracious to whom I will be gracious and will show mercy on whom I will show mercy. But he said, You cannot see my face, for no one shall see me and live. And the Lord continued, See, there is a place by me where you shall stand on the rock. And while my glory passes by, I will put you in a cleft of the rock, and I will cover you with my hand until I have passed by. Then I will take away my hand, and you shall see my back, but my face shall not be seen. Chapter 34. The Lord said to Moses, Cut two tablets of stone like the former ones, and I will write on the tablet the words that were on the former tablets, which you broke. Be ready in the morning and come up in the morning to Mount Sinai and present yourself there to me. On the top of the mountain, no one shall come up with you, and do not let anyone be seen throughout all the mountain, and do not let flocks or herds or hearts brace in front of that mountain. So Moses cut two tablets of stone like the former ones, and he rose early in the morning and went up on Mount Sinai, as the Lord had commanded him, and took in his hand the two tablets of stone. The Lord descended in the cloud and stood with him there and proclaimed the name. The Lord passed before him and proclaimed, the Lord, a God merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness, keeping steadfast love for the thousands generation, forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin, yet by no means clearing the guilty, but visiting the iniquity of the parents upon the children and the children's children to the third and the fourth generation. And Moses quickly bowed his head towards the earth and worshipped. He said, If now I have found favor in your sight, O Lord, I pray, let the Lord go with us. Although this is a stiff-necked people, pardon our iniquity and our sin and take us for your inheritance. He said, I hereby make a covenant before all your people, I will perform marvels such as have not been performed in all the earth or in any nation. And all the people among whom you live shall see the work of the Lord. For it is an awesome thing that I will do with you. Observe what I command you today See, I will drive out before you the Amorites, the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites. Take care not to make a covenant with the inhabitants of the land to which you are going, or it will become a snare among you. You shall tear down their altars, break their pillars, and cut down their sacred poles. For you shall worship no other god before the Lord, whose name is Jealous, is a jealous God. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. The second speaker reading shall be taken from the Gospel according to John, chapter 21, from verse 1 to 6 and 14 to 17. Let us hear the word of God. John chapter 21, 1 to 6. After these things, Jesus showed himself again to the disciples by the Sea of Tiberias, and he showed himself in this way. Gathered there together were Simon Peter, Thomas called the twin, Nathanael of Cana in Galilee, the son of Zebedee, and two others of his disciples, Simon Peter. Simon Peter said to them, "I am going fishing." They said to him, "We will go with you." They went out and got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. Just after daybreak, Jesus stood on the beach, but the disciples did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to them, "Children, you have no fish, have you?" They answered him, "No." He said to them, "Cast the net to the right side of the boat, and you will find some." So they cast it, and now they were not able to haul it in because there were so many fish. Verse 14 to 17. This was not the third time that Jesus appeared to the disciples after he was raised from the dead. When they had finished breakfast, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than this?" He said to him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my lambs." A second time he said to him, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" He said to him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Tend my sheep." He said to him the third time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter felt hurt because he said to him the third time, "Do you love me?" And he said to him, "Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep." May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you because the entrance of your word bringeth light. Thank you for today, solution hour number 31. Thank you for bringing us together here. We know that whenever you bring your people together, you always have something to say to them. So speak to each and every one of us from your throne of mercy and grace at this time to break you, to reveal yourself more unto us, to grant us solutions to diverse challenges that we may have in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Blessed be your holy name. Thank you for your faithfulness. In Jesus' mighty and victorious name, we give you praise. Amen. The first thing we are going to be looking at when we look at these two passages, I hear people, I discern that those of us here and those who will come to watch this episode of Solution R, we'll be looking at the two passages. Where is the correlation? Hold that in one hand as a nugget. We are going to come back to that presently. But let me remind us, previous week, Sunday, which was the 31st of the month of March, March 31, which was 13 days ago, we commemorated the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, Easter 2024. From that day and another 40 days, he will keep appearing to his disciples, revealing himself in the flesh, so no one thinks he's a ghost. Revealing himself in the flesh to confirm his resurrection. Amen. And in these 40 days, he imparted so many life lessons to them. And that's part of what we want to glean as believers today. In the passage we read in John chapter 21, we had to paraphrase. If you want, when you go home, read the entire chapter, if you want. But we can pick out the key lessons there. According to Apostle John, this was the third appearance. In the 20th chapter, he recorded the first and second appearances. According to him, this was the third appearance. Now, if you look at the synoptics from Matthew, Mark, and Luke, you will see other appearances. But let's stay focused here. What are the key lessons in this encounter? Number one, John 21 and verse 1 says, after these things, Jesus showed himself again, yet again, and this time at the Sea of Tiberias. The Sea of Tiberias is also the Sea of Galilee. So we know, same sea. And this is the same place that Apostle Peter had been fishing before our Lord called him. The Bible says they were together and he decided to go ahead and keep on fishing. So he went back. Now, what do you think made him go back? Is it not interesting? He and John the Beloved, of course, Mary Magdalene was the first to get there, but he and John the Beloved had seen an empty tomb. They knew the Lord had resurrected. The Lord had appeared twice. Why would he want to go back to fishing? Now, in any case, when he went fishing, he caught nothing. So, verse 6, you know, we remember we are holding in our hands the nugget of the correlation. Note again, verse 6, John 21 and verse 6. And Jesus said unto them, cast the net on the right side of the ship, and you shall find. They obeyed. And they were not able to draw the fish for the multitude of fish that they caught. And there are some powerful lessons for us there. Some of us, we believe that God is too slow to act concerning certain areas of our lives. And we go right back to trusting ourselves. We go right back to doing things the way we think we know we ought to do them. But this story will continue to tell us for ages to come until the parousia, until Jesus comes again. This encounter, his third appearance, according to Apostle John, will continue to remind us that without God, without our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we can do nothing. But when he came on the scene and redirected them, they achieved a catch beyond their imaginations. These are powerful lessons. And you know, sometimes we hear these messages and we say, oh, I've heard it before. Are we more intimate with the Lord than Peter, who had been with him for 3 years, who has seen him raise Lazarus from the dead, who has seen him do miracles, feed thousands, 5,000 in one instance, 4,000 men plus women and children. So we need a constancy. We need to be constant, if you like, consistently constant, if you like, to be able to gain all of the benefits of what God wants to teach us. Are there areas of our lives? Let's think. Let's reflect. When we come back and left fundamentally what God wants us to do. It was only after he granted them that revelation, look at verse 7, 27. Therefore, when they saw that great miracle, the disciple whom Jesus loved, that's John, the writer of this, the recorder of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ here, said unto Peter, it is the Lord. When they saw the manifestation of his power, they received fresh revelation and they were reminded. Some of us want to wait until something great and mighty happens before we remember. No, we should continually be in remembrance of divine awareness of our connection with him. That's a powerful message as well, shooting out at us from this encounter. Then let's go real quick to the concluding verses of our text. Verses 15, verses 16, and verse 17. After he had fed them, he focused on Simon Peter. He focused on him. And he said to him, Simon Peter, son of Jonah, do you love me more than this? Here, he uses the plural, these. It could mean two things. Do you love me more than the other disciples love me? It could also mean, do you love me more than you love your fishing? Do you have another God beside me? Do you have other idols, points of interest, points of priority over and above me? And you know, he was talking of agape love, sacrificial. But look at Peter's response. He said, Lord, you know that I love you. So our Lord Jesus Christ used agape. Peter replied at first, Philios, I love you. I love you. That's Philios. And what did God say to him? Feed my lambs. Who are his lambs? New covenants. Lambs are babies. Feed my lambs. They need attention. He wanted them to care for them. Now remember, the next time he asked him, Simon, do you love me? The second time, he said, Lord, you know I love you. He was now beginning to look at other dimensions of love. He said, I love you. Then he said, feed my sheep. Sheep are older believers. Tend to them, care for them. Spread the word. Let your life be an example, illustration. Be a living epistle unto them. Then he asked him the third time, Simon, son of Jonah, do you love me? This time, he uses the same way that Peter had used the word, Philios. And he was grieved. He said unto him, Lord, you know I love you. Then he said, feed my sheep a second time. Now, a lot of us, as students of the Bible, believe that part of why our Lord Jesus Christ asked him these three times was also to restore him. Because three times he denied our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So we believe one of the reasons why he took it three times, asked him three times, listened to him three times, is to restore him from where he was before his time of denial. We also believe that he asked him three times to confirm, because the word of God says in the mouth of two or three witnesses, a case is established. But in a case of taking a matter three times, three being the number of what? Completeness. To complete. We also believe that. We also believe that God is so merciful. And then you see the connection. If we go to the Old Testament, this was Moses speaking face to face with Almighty God. And remember, one thing he asked of the Lord, amongst everything he says, in Exodus 33:14, he says, Lord, please let your presence go with us. And what does 14 say? And the Lord said, my presence shall go with you, and I will give you rest. In verse 15, Moses said, because if you won't go with us, we won't go at all. As long as you look and remember that story, that encounter, we're making the correlation, taking the life lessons, we will realize that as long as they didn't have the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ, they accomplished nothing. And that's why in Methodist Church, when we go through our covenant services and read John chapter 15, we remember the word of God that teaches us that if we abide in him and his words abide in us, we can ask and we will do even beyond our imaginations. And he teaches that without us, we can do nothing. Look again at Exodus 34, now verse 6. And the Lord passed before him to reveal to him his glory. And what did the Lord call his glory? He says, the Lord God, merciful and gracious, long-suffering, and abundant in goodness and truth. Mercy he expressed as the focal point of his glory. And even if we look at the finished work of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, love manifested mercy. Mercy gave you and I and all of creation the opportunity to be reconciled unto the Lord. Verse 7, he says, keeping mercy for thousands of generations, forgiving iniquity and transgression and sin, keeping his covenant. He's the covenant-keeping God. On our side, he asks very little from us. On his own side, he gives us those things our human capacity cannot achieve. Finally, look at Exodus 34:14. He says, for you shall worship no other God. For the Lord, whose name is jealous, is a jealous God. And you see yet again another correlation. In a short while, Peter went back to his usual trade, business as usual. And God is speaking to somebody here. Maybe you think God is slow in answering your prayers in any area of your life, and you have decided it's business as usual. Listen, the passages we've read today remind us of God's unfailing love, mercies, and grace. The passages we've read today remind us of the power of his presence and what we can achieve, not by ourselves, but in him and through him. This morning, God has reminded us that God is asking very little from us, and yet he's so, so willing to give so much unto us. The question to all of us, which we must ask ourselves, is where in any area of our lives have we taken our focus away from him and put them into other gods? Just turn it into a prayer right now and say, Lord, I rededicate myself unto you. Today and right now, I rededicate my life unto you. Father, look upon me with mercy. In every area that I have denied you, forsaken you, in every area I have sought other gods, in every area I have provoked your jealousy, let mercy prevail over judgment. You know, sometimes we think we can do better than God, because God in his infinite mercies is doing it in the way of perfection. And in our imperfections, we say, Lord, I can do it better. And then when we bring our imperfections, we do it worse. But just speak to God at this time and ask for grace, 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 grace to harness just his mercy, his love, his grace. It's sufficient is able to grant us the dominion and victory. Remember, without him, we can do nothing. I thank him for the privilege of being his sons and daughters with our names written in heaven. That privilege is what allows us, permits us, leverages us to be victorious. Pray that we will continue to enjoy that privilege in every area of our lives. Pray at this time, remembering anybody that is connected to us, that is yet to know and harness the love of God, the finished work of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ on the cross of Calvary, his grace. Anyone connected to us that is yet to harness the mercy. This morning on the prayer mountain, we are saying, Lord, teach us how to preach the gospel in these contemporary times without trespassing. Oh, Lord God, teach us how to be a great and faithful and efficient and impactful ambassadors for you in an ever-changing, dynamic, challenging world without, oh, Lord God, without in any way trespassing. Teach us how, Father God Almighty, to be channels of salvation and deliverance unto humanity in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Precious Redeemer, we thank you for a wonderful time in your presence. Thank you for what you have taught us today. We pray you amplify the life lessons from what you've taught us today, and that you grant us grace and wisdom to apply them to your glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Precious Redeemer, we intercede for your church universal. We pray that by your mercies and your grace, O Lord God, the church will march on, will impact, will be ambassadors for you, reconciling men unto you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Blessed Redeemer. Pray for our own church here, the Diocese of USA, that you continue to work in us and through us, O Lord God, as you told them to cast their net in the divine supernatural direction. They caught more than they had ever caught. Father, grant us grace to win souls for you and spread scriptural holiness across the USA, across its regions, and globally, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We pray that you confirm your word, confirm our ministries, whether ordained or lay, with miracles, signs, and wonders, to your glory, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we lift up nations, the United States, Nigeria, Sierra Leone, Ghana, nations represented, Cameroon and others, here in our diocese, that you continue to bless and heal these nations and grant wisdom to the leaders of these nations, that they will act in righteousness and lead the people in the way of justice and peace in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
For
us in the U.S., election 2024, let your presence, you said you will grant us the blessings of your presence and you will grant us peace and rest. Grant us peace and rest in this U.S. by giving us the best president ever in this year's elections, according to your sovereign will, in the name of Jesus Christ. Heal Nigeria of poverty, of insecurity, heal us of corruption, heal us of our challenges. Grant wisdom to the leadership of Nigeria, Ghana, Cameroon, Sierra Leone, countries here represented in this diocese, the exalted in our midst. We pray for bereaved families, comfort them. We pray for travelers. Journey mercies, O Lord God, unto all of them. In the name of Jesus. Anyone that is ill here, we pray that because we've come unto you and healing is our bread, and by the stripes of Jesus we are healed, grant us healing and take all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Blessed Redeemer. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Glory and honor be yours in the highest. In Jesus, matchless and victorious name, we give you praise.
Amen.
Amen. Worthy, worthy, worthy is the Lamb.
Hallelujah.
We just want to thank everyone for coming to Solution Hour number 31. It's been an awesome time in God's presence. We still have about 10 more minutes. And in these 10 minutes, the next 5 or so minutes, we are going to dedicate to prophetic prayers. Prophetic prayers. And we pray at this time as we yield ourselves that God himself will lift burdens in our lives, break yoke in our lives, and be exalted and glorified in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
What is the Lamb?
Hallelujah.
Hold the glory, Father. The glory, Son. The glory, Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
You deserve them all. The glory. The glory, Father. Take glory, Son. Take glory, Holy Ghost. You deserve them all. Our dear Heavenly Father, you are the Almighty Father, you are the Almighty God. Immortal, invisible God, only wise.
Amen.
We all come before you because we believe it is a time to fellowship with one another. Mm-hmm. And where two or three people gather together in your name, you are there. Yes. Thank you for what you have done in our midst this morning. Thank you for the word of exhortation.
Thank you
for the blessings that have already come, be imparted in our lives. Thank you because eyes have not seen,
Amen.
Ears have not heard.
Amen.
It has not entered the heart of man what God Amen. Has done to those who love him. Lord, to this morning we believe that the angels of heaven are rejoicing because of the things that have done to us this morning. And thank you because of what you are going to do in our lives.
Amen.
Lord, we lift ourselves unto you. Prophetically, we believe that surely goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives.
Amen.
We are looking up unto you. Is there any desire in our heart? Is there any trial? Is there any challenges? Is there any tribulations? Is there any problems? Lord, we pray according to the Bible. The Bible says, ask and ye shall be given. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and the door shall be open. Lord, every problem, challenges, trial. Lord, the Bible says, be open, Ephrata. Lord, we declare your supremacy, we declare your authority.
Amen.
Every Amen. Problem Amen. Over every trial, over every sickness, over every tribulation, we come against it right now in the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Your freedom, we receive your healing, we receive your deliverance,
Amen.
We receive your strength, we receive your healing.
Amen.
The Bible says, what is the Lamb that was slain to receive yes. power, to receive yes, glory, to receive yes, might, to receive anointing, to receive blessing. Lord, we say it and we declare it. Even Lord, as we are going to cross over to another week, let this be our portion in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Stand on our feet. Because according to the word of the Lord, the weapon of our warfare are not carnal. But they are mighty for the pulling down of strongholds, casting down every imagination, bring them into the captivity. Every idea that exalted itself against the Lord of God. Lord, is there any darknesses upon the faces of anyone gathered here this morning? Lord, we bring the light of the Almighty Father. We bring the light of God. The Bible said, let there be light, and there was light.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Lord, we pray, Lord, upon every darkness, we show your light in the Amen. Name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we stand upon the throne of grace so that we may obtain mercy.
Mm.
Even yes. as we are going to cross over to another new week,
in the name
Lord,
of Jesus.
We pray, we are going to be favorably considered. In every area of our lives, we say, Lord, we receive your favor.
Amen.
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 Lord, in the name of Jesus,
Amen.
We declare today, in the name of Jesus,
Amen.
On this morning, we set ourselves aside for witnessing. Lord, we pray upon all of us gathered here. Let the power of witnessing, telling people about Jesus, sharing the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ,
in the name
showing the love of God to one another. Lord, let it be our portion. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We pray in the name of Jesus. Even as we gather here this morning, is anyone having problem at their places of work?
In Lord, the name of Jesus.
This morning, we declare your help. The Bible says you are our refuge, our fortress. Lord, a very present help in time of trouble. Lord, we declare you will help us in the name of Jesus. You will help us in the name of Jesus. You will help us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We say, David said, one thing I seek after, Lord, that to seek the face of the Lord and to dwell in the tabernacle of the Almighty.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
Lord.
Even
Lord, as we hide ourselves under your tabernacle this morning,
in the name of Jesus,
lo and behold, in the name of Jesus, no weapon of enemy, no weapon of evil ones shall touch us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we ask God upon whatever desire that we bring this morning, Lord, even this week, the Bible says, it shall turn to you a testimony.
Amen.
Lord, in the name of Jesus, it will be our testimony. 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 In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, in the name of Jesus, we remember one of us, very Reverend Sue in Wachuku, who has traveled to Nigeria. Lord, we pray, we declare that program will be successful.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Commendation service, and it was successful.
Amen.
Lord, we pray every other program will be successful. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Even as they traveled, Lord, we pray they will come back with testimony. In
Amen.
The name of Jesus, you will protect them. You will guide them. Lord, you will show them mercy. You will show them faith. Even upon the traveling from one place to the other, Lord, we declare safety in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We declare safety in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, we pray even upon all our older people. Lord, in the name of Jesus, as we use all our people, of our members who are older, who are of age in our midst, Lord, even this time, oh God, we pray you go to renew their strength.
Amen.
Lord, renew their strength.
Amen.
God, renew their strength.
Amen.
God, renew their strength. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Even Lord, we pray upon those who are young, the little ones among us, wherever they are
Jesus.
Right now, we pray that you go to protect them. You go to protect them for us. You're going to energize them for us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And we pray for those who are walking. Those who are walking among us, oh God, we pray for blessing in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We pray you're going to bless them. You're going to help them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Even
Amen.
As we declare our diocese, we declare
Lord.
Prosperity.
Amen.
We declare reaching. We declare
Amen.
Expansion.
Amen.
We declare flourishing
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, as we are moving forward, we are not going to move backward
in
the name of
Jesus.
Jesus. Lord, upon the date for inauguration,
Lord,
we are looking up unto you. You will perfect the date and you
Amen.
Will bring it to a completion in
Amen.
The name of Jesus.
Amen.
It will turn to us a testimony in
Amen.
The name of Jesus.
Amen.
Even though we involve in traveling from one place to the other,
the
we declare safety
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, sir. Lord, we
Thank
bless
you, Lord.
Your name. We
Hallelujah.
Give honor and praises unto your holy name.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
In
Thank you, Father.
Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen. And as we have seen in Exodus 34, verses 6 and 7, and John 21, verses 6 and 7, Lord, as we conclude Solution Hour number 31, Let all of us enjoy your mercy.
Amen.
Enjoy your grace.
Amen.
Enjoy your goodness.
Amen.
Enjoy your favor.
Amen.
Enjoy, O Lord God, showers of your blessings and your presence.
Amen.
And so with gladness and gratitude, we confess together, surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us
all the days of our life.
And we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever
and ever. Amen.
The grace in fellowship, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore.
Amen.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Hallelujah.